I do have some truck content for those of you that only watch my channel for the truck stuff.
So we're over here at Tron Auto Lab and the Focus is done. Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video we are finally going to be picking up the Ford Focus after the wrap has been done. Normally I kind of show you guys the whole wrapping process, but this time I've kind of kept it under the wraps. You see what I did there? But first off, we are actually taking the Ford Ranger down to Provo. We're going to be doing some videos down there with it, and I've got an update on this truck. Don't worry, we will be getting into the Focus shortly, but I did want to mention with the Ranger, it's been really easy to clean this truck. Like, the exterior has been really easy to wash, make it look pretty for the videos. I mean, you guys can see it's not perfect, but it looks good for the video. But the thing I want to mention is the interior. So if you guys don't know, during the off-roading video, my friend Dex that was out there with us decided to do some donuts in his Tacoma while I had the doors open to the Ranger. And so, well, what happened is the truck got completely covered in dust. But as you guys can see, I got the truck, I mean, you guys can see down here, still has tons of dust in it because I haven't cleaned the mats. But the rest of the truck, like the seats and everything, they were really easy to get cleaned off. You guys are wondering if it looks like this because it's Alcantara, so depending on which way it goes will determine what it looks like. But yeah, this truck's actually really easy to clean, so that's a huge plus. Obviously, being an off-road truck, the interior being easy to clean is a huge plus, because if you take it off-road, it's going to get dirty. And yeah, having all of the like plastic and everything is really easy to clean, and then all these like leather bits and the Alcantara and all that, also really easy to clean. So yeah, but let's head out. A lot of people have been asking me what I actually think about the Ranger Tremor, and here's what I have to say is, so far I've actually really liked the truck. The only thing that's been weird about the truck, and the same thing happened with my Ford Raptor, is when the truck is warming up, the transmission's definitely a little bit weird, but as soon as the vehicle's warmed up, it performs flawlessly. And we have, wait for it, a Huracan. It's always cool to see those. But anyways, the truck's just a little bit weird when the transmission's warming up, but other than that, like, performs flawlessly. Now, aside from all that, and I don't want to spend too much time on this because, again, this video is supposed to be about the Focus, but the truck's super smooth, really daily drivable, and I guess this pretty much says it all. So if I was in the market for a mid-sized truck, here are the trucks that I'd be looking at. I would first off be looking at a Tacoma TRD Pro with, obviously it has a V6, but with the probably the manual transmission, because I think that's pretty neat. Or I would be looking at a Jeep Gladiator Rubicon with the EcoDiesel, or I would be looking at this truck. Now, the thing about this compared to the other two is, yes, the Tacoma TRD Pro has a similar MSRP, but Toyota dealers charge way over MSRP, so this is actually cheaper because of how much Toyota dealers charge. And then the EcoDiesel Gladiator Rubicon is way more expensive. And so, like, if I wanted the best bang for my buck, I would go for this one. But then if money wasn't an option, I'd probably get the Gladiator. But obviously, money is always a consideration. And so, like, as a mid-sized truck, I think this is the one that I'd go for in the Tremor package until they release a Ranger Raptor. That thing, that'll be fun. So we're over here at Tron Auto Lab and the Focus is done. But before we go over the wrap on the Focus, we have some cool cars in here. So first off, we have this Z06 Corvette, which is getting wrapped in shadow black, which obviously the car is already black, so you guys can kind of imagine it's going to be pretty cool. But you've got the red brake calipers, which is pretty neat. But the fun products over here at Tron is this Hellcat, and also this Jeep Grand Cherokee that is getting all of the stuff blacked out on it. Just kidding. But this Hellcat already has an aftermarket exhaust. You can see that you've got the super wide, super sticky tires that pop out in normal, or I should say old school muscle car fashion. But we are putting a pulley on this and some other stuff, tuning it. Should have 800 horsepower to the wheels when it's done. Let me know if you guys want me to review this once it's done. I think it'd be fun to review a modified Hellcat, but this car stock doesn't get any traction. So now with 800 horsepower to the wheels, it's really not gonna get any traction. So yeah, but it's also pretty cool to see like the whole Hellcat powertrain in an actual Hellcat versus what I'm used to seeing it, which is my truck. And yeah, so that's all that, and let's see the Focus. I won't make you guys wait any longer. Here is the finished product. It looks absolutely amazing. Now, we do still have to do the stripes. That'll probably happen in the near future, but let's actually take a look at the whole wrap. So yes, I wrapped it purple. I have wanted a purple car for the longest time, but I haven't, because the Stradman wraps all of his cars in purple, and I didn't want to be just another YouTuber with a purple car, but he's kind of recently gone away from doing purple, so like I now finally have a chance to wrap a car purple, and I feel like it goes perfectly with the whole theme of the RS. Just looks absolutely fantastic. So this is a satin purple. This was not my first color choice. We went through like three or four different
different purples, but everything was on back order or it just wasn't available whatsoever. And so this is the color we ended with, and I actually really like the look of it. So it's a satin kind of metallic purple. So if you guys can see right here, you can see a little bit of metallic flake. It looks really good. It makes the body lines on the car pop so much more, and it goes way better with the bronze wheels compared to the white. And I know the blue might look a little bit funny, but I actually really like the accenting between the purple and the blue. I think it looks really neat because obviously we've got the blue of the brake caliper, and then you have the blue of the RS badge. And then, yes, we did dip the Ford badges so that we don't have too much going on, and that looks really good how that's been done. And then notice the mirrors in purple, and then we've got the wrapped roof. So we did carbon fiber weave for the wrap on the roof, and this is a textured carbon fiber so that it kind of contrasts a little bit better compared to the purple. And then you can see you've got the purple here on the side, which looks really good. And then we've got everything here on the back. Just, yeah, looks really good. I love the exhaust tip set up here, and like how like this is all black on the bottom, and then you've got like the purple, and then you have the black of the rear window, and then the badge, and then here on the wing, and then the carbon fiber, and the purple down the side. Looks really good. Definitely probably need to change the taillights at this point because now they really stick out, but I mean, it's not too bad. So you guys probably noticed that there was a badge in the front, but there wasn't a badge in the back. That's because we just got it put on. So now we've got both of the RS badges, and normally I just debadge the cars fully, but the reason that I am keeping this badge on the back is because the badge on the front is an indentation in the bumper, which now I've got to walk all the way back. I didn't think this through very well, but the badge over here on the front, you can see that it's an actual indentation in the plastic, and so if you remove it, it'll just look funny. So I've got to keep the front badge, and if we're going to keep the front badge, we got to keep the rear badge. Well, we are heading back to my place, and oh my goodness, does the Focus look amazing. I'll give you guys a walk around in the outside, but, or not in the outside, outside. I cannot talk today. You know, I'm just going to go. The Focus looks so good while it is moving. Oh my goodness. We are back at Tron Auto Lab because we just dropped Doug off. He helped me get the Ranger and then this car back, and then obviously we're taking the Focus back. But I am so excited to drive this car again. It feels so fun to drive. I do need to get gas. I have 25 miles until I'm empty, so we're gonna get gas. But just seeing the purple is so cool. And I'll give you guys a better walk around, again, outside as soon as I get home and get this filled up with gas. Well, I am back home and I have to play a little bit of Car Tetris over the next few minutes so that I can get the Focus next to the TRX so that I can take the thumbnail for today's video and then also give you guys a walk around on the Focus. So it should be fun. And also, we have our favorite little doggo, Zorro, sitting there waiting. Well, we have officially made it. We are in the Focus. We are next to the TRX, and well, now I can give you guys the walk around. Now, my friends all told me that now I have kind of like a Joker combination because we have the purple with the green, but that's not cool enough for me. I feel like this is more of a Barney combination with the green and the purple. But yeah, the TRX next to the Focus RS, I think it looks really cool now that we have all of the purple on the Focus RS. And yeah, I just think this combination is just absolutely awesome. But yeah, it looks so good here in the sun. You can see the metallic flake way better now that we're out in the light, and it's not a great day today. It's kind of overcast, but it still looks really, really good. It actually looks nicer on camera than the wrap on the T-Rex. The wrap on the T-Rex, again, still looks mint green on camera, whereas in person it's like bright green. So like this truck looks better in person, but then this looks better on camera. So I guess that we win both ways in different ways. But yeah, it looks really good on the front end. And I know a lot of people were kind of concerned about the bronze wheels, but I think it really works with the purple. Like seeing this all together again, in person, it looks a little bit better. And especially with the fitment that these wheels have, you guys can see here on the side, it's pretty much like right at zero. I mean, this one might be slightly positive, but it's pretty much right at zero with that one. And this one might be just a little bit negative, right? It's popping out just a little bit, but it looks really good overall. Definitely, again, I know I've mentioned this a million times, but I think I definitely need to change the taillights. They don't look horrible now. They actually look better with this color than they do with the white, 100%. But yeah, definitely seen it next to the TRX finally. It looks really good. And if you guys are wondering, obviously, since it's a white car, when you open it up, you do see all of the white here on the door jams, all that kind of stuff. Now, you can get this wrapped, but once you wrap door jams, it makes it exponentially more expensive. And I mean, it's something that you only see for like 2 seconds, right? Because we've got the vinyl up into here and all that kind of stuff. And when you shut the door, you can't tell that the car is white. And the other thing is gonna be the gas cap as well. So right here, so if we just press the little gas cap button, you guys can see you've got the white on the back there. But I mean, other than when you're There we go. Other than when you're filling up the car and all that stuff, you're not gonna notice that it's white. But yeah, it looks so good. I want you guys to put in the comment section below if you think I should still do the stripes that we are planning. So obviously we have the whole roof with the carbon fiber here. And then the plan was to have the carbon fiber stripes come down and then also in the front end.
But yeah, let me know if you guys want me to still do the stripes. I'm kind of torn. Like, it looks really good like this, but I still think it would look even better if it had these stripes.
Now, something that's kind of a smaller detail, if you guys notice, this part right here is plastic. We didn't wrap it whatsoever. We wrapped this purple. Underneath here, we have the carbon fiber, but if you guys notice, I don't know if it's going to come through in the camera right here, we've got kind of like a satin black finish right here. This is actually plasti-dipped right there.
Now, the reason we did that is the Focus RS wing is really difficult to take apart.
Pretty much every single video of this wing getting taken apart ended with the whole thing breaking. We didn't want to do that, so we left the vehicle, or sorry, we left the wing intact, rather, and just dipped the insides right here so that it isn't white anymore.
And I think that's just a better fix rather than ordering out a whole new wing or trying to take the wing apart to wrap in there and then completely breaking the wing. And then obviously we could have left it white, but that wouldn't have looked good. And ultimately, if I ever want to take this off, which I won't, you literally can just peel it off because it's plastic dip. I know you guys get triggered because I plasti dipped the door handles on the T-Rex and now we've plasti dipped the Focus, but there's certain things that it just works really good for. I don't recommend doing it in mass on a car, but if you're doing it on small elements,
again, like door handles and like the inside part of a wing so that it's not white,
then I definitely think it's a good thing to do.
I do have some truck content for those of you that only watch my channel for the truck stuff, and you guys probably noticed that we've got a T-Rex here and it's got a rack and all that kind of stuff. Now, I'm not getting the rack, but the bumpers that this has, you guys can see the front bumper right there. This is going to be on the T-Rex. And then also we've got, let's go down a little bit, we've got the rear bumper. So yes, we have those ordered out for the truck. If you guys are wondering, I'm just gonna put this down right here.
When I first got the truck, if you don't remember, I took it into Addictive Desert Design so they could scan the T-Rex to build their bumpers off of it. Well, those are the bumpers that they developed. And so now we're getting those shipped out to the T-Rex. So obviously it's kind of like a trade deal,
right? I'm gonna be making videos with the T-Rex with those bumpers. And then also I let them have my truck for a few days so they could scan out and build out those bumpers.
So they're basically trading the bumpers for time with my T-Rex. And then also obviously it'll be on YouTube and all that kind of stuff. So I'm super excited to get it. I've always wanted Addictive Desert Design bumpers. I just haven't kept a vehicle long enough for me to be able to make sense of it.
But since I'm keeping the T-Rex for longer, it makes sense. And then also, I mean,
well, I can't say no to free.
That's gonna sum things up for our video with getting the Ford Focus RS wrapped. After I turn in the Ranger Tremor on Wednesday of this week,
then I'm just super excited to daily drive the Focus RS again. It's been an absolute blast to drive.
And I guess I have to make an update video on the T-Rex because I really haven't driven it all that much. I think I've put like maybe 100 miles on it in the last few weeks.
It's really hasn't been driven all that much, and I'll kind of explain that in a video in the future. But anyways, I'll see all of you guys in the next video.